Amen. Amen. Good morning, Black Chapel. Amen. The Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silent before him. I was glad where they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Okay, y'all a little bit too quiet in here. I said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise this morning. Amen. Amen. For this is indeed another day that the Lord has made. Amen. And we are going to rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. 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 Well, while we're waiting for our choir to be in place, let's proceed on with our responsive reading. Let's all please stand. Our responsive reading comes from 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, the 55th through the 58th verse. If we have found it, let the church say, praise the Lord. And it reads as follows. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? But thanks be to God, which gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Altogether, therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Amen. Amen. Our hymn of praise, he's sweet, I know. Okay, we're gonna have our choir come in first, and then we're gonna proceed with our hymn of praise. Amen. Thank you. Amen. 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 Let's continue standing as we proceed on with our hymn of praise. He's sweet, I know. He's sweet, I know. He's sweet, I know. Storm clouds may rise, strong winds may blow. I'll tell the world wherever I go that I found a Savior, and He's sweet, I know. I can't forget when I was sad, head hanging down, so feeling bad. All I could say, Lord, take my heart. Jesus heard and saved me and gave me a start. Oh, He's sweet, I know. He's sweet, I know. Storm clouds may rise, strong winds may blow. I'll tell the world wherever I go that I found a Savior, and He's sweet, I know. I have my ticket here in my hand. I'm going to that beautiful land. Sometimes I weep and sometimes I moan, but I'm bound for glory and I'm going on. Say, He's sweet, I know. Oh, He's sweet, I know. Storm clouds may rise and storm wind may blow. Wherever I go, that I found a Savior, and He's sweet, I know. Oh, He's sweet, I know. He's sweet, I know. Storm clouds may rise and strong winds may blow. Yes, I'll tell the world wherever I go that I found a Savior, and
Let's give God a hand clap of praise this morning. Amen. Let's give God a hand clap of praise this morning. Amen. Is he sweet? Is he sweet? I know he is. I know I got some witnesses out there who can testify that he is sweet. Amen. You may be seated, and now we turn you over to our deacons for devotion.
Amen. Amen. God is definitely good. Thank you, God, for allowing us to be here this second Sunday in this second month of year 2023. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Amen. Oh, Heavenly Father, Father God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Oh, Heavenly Father, Lord, we come to you right now just asking you to hear our desired prayers, Father God. But first, we want to thank you for all you've done, you're doing, and you continue doing our life, Father God. Thank you for your grace, your mercy, your favor, your love, your protection. Thank you for your forgiveness. Thank you for all that you do, Father God. Father God, we ask that you bless the sick and shut in, oh Heavenly Father. Lord, bless the sick and shut in our church, around our community, in our world, Father God. Now let, Father God, please help us with our youth and this gun violence, Father God. Father God, please send an intervention, Father God. Father God, please let them know it's another way besides violence, Father God. Father God, bless our teachers, Father God. Bless our healthcare professionals, Father God. Father God, bless those who travel the highways and byways just to make a living, Father God. Father God, bless their mother right now, wondering how she's going to make ends meet, Father God. Father God, figure out a way to make it happen for her, Father God. Father God, bless their child that's on the verge of suicide or depression, Father God. Please send the right person to his or her way, Father God. And let her know that serving God has a lot of benefits, oh Heavenly Father. Father God, bless our church, Father God. You know the needs that we have, Father God. Father God, we ask that you would just bless us with those needs and that we would continue to give you the glory, the praise, and honor. Father God, bless our pastor, bless the first family. Lord, please bless sister and brother Bell, Father God, to a speedy recovery. Father God, continue to bless all our sick and shut in, Father God. And Father God, whatever problem someone has walked into this sanctuary with, Father God, please bless them with desires of their heart, Father God. Let them know that it's all well and that you can solve all problems, Father God. Father God, again, thank you for everything you've done, you're doing, you're going to do, Father God. We can't do anything without you, but Father God, we need you. We need you every second, every minute, every hour, every month, every week. Father God, every year we need you, Father God. And we know that you're able to do above and abundantly, Father God. We're just humbly submitting ourselves this morning, Father God. Father God, we know it's Super Bowl Sunday, but I look at it as Super Soul Sunday, Father God. If we can save some souls, Father God, that'll be the biggest victory today, Father God. Father God, just thank you for being the God of who I am, Father God. We can always call on you, Father God. You're the great I am, Father God. Me plus you plus God outweighs anyone, Father God. Father God, continue to be in our corner, Father God. Continue to help us fight this race, Father God. That in the end of this race, that we may give you the glory, the praise, and honor. Father God, bless those who are in the sanctuary and bless those who are watching us on the worldwide web, Father God. Father God, continue to just bless us, and we'll be a blessing to others. Again, thank you for your grace, your mercy, your favor, your love, and your protection. And Father God, continue to use us that you may get the glory, the praise, and honor. These and all of us we ask in your Son Jesus' name. We pray and give thanks. Amen.
Some of y'all believe that you can put it all in his hands. I know I got some witnesses who can testify on what happens when you put everything in his hands. Amen. As the saints used to say, show some sign. Amen. Amen. God bless you, male choir. Amen. For that reminder. Yeah. Amen. Amen. Now we move that we acknowledge our visitors. Amen. Those who are visiting us the first time, like, but it may not be your first time, but we still want to greet you and acknowledge you in the name of the Lord. And also those who are watching us via live stream, via Facebook, we welcome you as well. Amen. And, you know, our pastor later on will come and welcome you on his own. But with all of our visitors, please stand. Amen. Those who are in the sanctuary, please stand.
Yes, amen. Amen.
Amen. God bless you, brother.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. God bless you, sister. Amen. Here we go.
I love you with the love. Love you with the love of the Lord. I can see in you the glory of our King, and I love you with the love of the Lord. I love you with the love of the Lord. I love you with the love of the Lord. in you, the glory of our King, and I love you with the love of the Lord.
Amen, amen, amen. We sincerely pray here at Black Chapel that something is said, something is said, but most of all, something that would be preached would be a help and a strength to your journey with Christ. May God bless you. May God keep you and have a blessed week. And we turn you over to, well, our announcer, Sister Love.
Amen. Good morning again, Black Chapel.
Good morning.
Black Chapel Baptist Church, the Black History Fellowship Dinner, TASTE, will be celebrated on Sunday, February 26th, immediately after service in the Fellowship Hall.
Amen.
The food will be provided and a committee will prepare it. All members are asked or feel free to dress in your African attire to attend this celebration. Again, it's a Black History Fellowship Dinner TASTE.
Amen.
The Couples Ministry will celebrate Valentine's Day on Friday, February 17th at Mr. D's. It's in Crystal Springs. The address is 105 East Georgetown Street. The restaurant closes at 9. The fellowship will begin at 6. All couples are invited.
Amen.
As a reminder, all members may pick up their 2022 tax statements from the office.
Amen.
Our prayer list, we have Sister Mary Cooper, mother of Dennis Williams,
amen,
Deacon Charles and Sister Madeline Bell,
amen,
Tyler Pfizer, that's the nephew of Mother Wyndham and Deacon Melvin Pfizer, Brother Turner Curry, Joshua Henderson, Sister Jessie Bell Williams, that's the mother of Brother Curtis Watson, and we want to be in prayer for the family of Gracie Rattler and the demise of her mother.
Amen.
And any other members that we are unaware of. Our birthdays for the week. On Monday the 13th, we have Ashton Ross. On the 18th, we have Brother Cleveland Bingham.
Right,
and today
amen.
We have two birthdays.
Amen.
We have Mother Madeline Bell.
Amen.
And Brother Louis Bridges. If you all are watching, happy birthday, members.
Amen.
Good morning, Black's Chapel.
Good morning.
Good morning, Black's Chapel.
Good morning.
Good morning, Black's Chapel.
Good morning.
I'm so glad to be here today.
Amen.
A lot of people had
amen.
Planned on being here today.
Amen.
But some reason they didn't make it. I'm here to give you your Black History moment.
Amen.
And this person we're talking about today is phenomenal.
Right.
Her name is Shirley Caesar Williams. She was born in 1938 in Durham, North Carolina. She is a bishop. She is a philanthropist. She's an entertainer. She's a gospel singer. She's a mother, a grandmother, a missionary. Anything she has set out to do, she has conquered it. But I'm focused on the song that she wrote in 1973. She recorded this song in 1973. So, go with me, Mr. Look, go with me, Mr. Mayberry.
Amen.
Yes, God.
Thank you.
for me.
Yeah,
yeah. Oh Lord.
Yeah.
May the works I done speak for me.
Yeah.
When I'm resting in my grave, nothing else can be said. May the works I've done, may it speak for me, oh Lord. May the life I live speak for me, oh Lord, yes it will. May the life I live speak for me. When I'm resting in my grave, there'll be nothing, nothing else to be said. May the words that I done, may you speak for me. May my hands, everything that I touch, may it speak for me. Yes, it will. Lay my hands, everything that I touch, may it speak for me.
Glory be to God. Thank you, Evangelist Wooder, for
Amen.
Blessing us.
Amen.
Yes, yes, may the work I've done speak for me. Come
to receive my blessing.
Patiently waiting
for the harvest
is now. I got the Hebrews 11 and 1 faith.
The kind of faith.
And it's mine.
Oh, mine.
And it's harvest time.
Listen,
and I'm standing on your promise. Everything
I believe,
that I speak,
I believe
you give it to me. Now it's the Father's
good
pleasure that the kingdom is mine and is mine. That kind of faith. The kingdom is mine. Oh, it's mine.
It's mine.
Oh, mine.
Oh, mine.
Oh, Lord.
All is mine.
Oh, Lordy.
Oh, Lord, I come.
I come to receive. My faith hasn't wavered. No, 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 no. I'm holding on. What the Lord said to me. Every day, He keeps on blessing me. And it's mine. Because I decree it. And the Bible says, if I decree it, you will establish it. A blessing for me.
Yeah.
If I speak it, I can receive it. Of
my blessing.
Oh Lord. I'm going to say it again. Yeah! say it one more time.
God bless you with your name on it. How many of you know that you really got a name with your blessing on it? If you know you got a blessing with your name on it, stand up on your feet. New job. Somebody gonna get that house.
I've been waiting a long time.
Somebody gonna get a good doctor's report. Hallelujah. 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 Man, the Bible says, speak those things as though they were. Amen. Man, come on, Deacon Brian.
My blessing on the way.
Yeah. All right.
All right.
All right. All right.
Yes, sir. Amen. Amen.
Yes,
sir. Amen.
Yes, sir.
My blessing.
Hallelujah.
Need a little help, deacons.
Yes, sir.
Need a little help down here. Give me a little more volume, please. Good morning. It's a good morning to be in the house of the Lord. There's a lot of places we could have been this morning. Super Bowl's getting ready to kick off later on today. Parties going to be all over the country. celebration. There's a lot of places we could have been. Right. But thank God we're in God's house. The right place to be on a Sunday morning. Amen. Amen. Listen. You've heard the excuse that there's no excuse for breaking the law. You've heard that. Well, quite a while back, I was on my way going somewhere at night, and I was in a hurry, and I was cruising along, minding my own business, and all of a sudden, there's blue lights behind me. And the guy got out, walked up to my car. I said, man, I didn't know I was speeding. He said, listen, you were speeding and I caught you. This is cut and dry. Ain't no sense of you talking. This is cut and dry. I caught you. Why did I say that? It's in the Bible when it comes to tithes.
Yes.
It's in the Bible when it comes to tithes. It's cut and dry.
Yes.
There's no excuse for any of us not to pay tithes.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord said we owe that. And to make it simple so we can understand, he said 10%.
Yes.
He didn't say figure it out on yourself. He said 10%. That's the Bible. Cut and dry. Yes. You can't add to that and you can't take away from that. Now, I don't want you to say that nobody never told me. Mm-hmm. I've never heard it. I'm telling you now. Listen, these envelopes that we fill out, you look at these envelopes. There's different categories on this envelope. Mm-hmm. But at the very top, the most important one, it says tithes.
Right.
Now, when you give money to the maintenance, repair, benevolent, public offer, pastor aid, Sunday school, special offer, revival, all of those are not tithes.
Amen.
Those are offerings.
Right.
Those are gifts. Those are gifts. You are not paying tithe when you're giving those different categories.
Amen.
Tithe is stand by itself. That's Amen. What the Lord said.
Amen.
You owe me that.
Witness.
Now, if you prove me wrong, I'll stop saying it.
Amen.
If you prove me wrong, I'll stop saying it.
Amen.
But we owe the 10% to the Lord and these other categories of what you give for offering. And you stop calling those, I pay my tithe because I gave him the benevolent offering. You did not pay your tithe. And listen.
Amen.
The Lord says you're cursed with a curse because you didn't do it.
Amen.
The pastor talks about it.
Amen.
It's in your Bible.
Amen.
You've heard all of us get, we heard of us get up here talking about it, tithes and offering. So you can't say, I didn't know it. Ignorance to it, I didn't know it. Because
right.
we're telling you now.
Yeah.
So you don't have no excuse for not paying your tithe.
Mm-hmm.
Listen. I'm the chairman of the finance. I see your envelope. I tip my hat to a lot of you.
Amen.
You are paying your tithe.
Amen.
You pay your tithe, then you give off. Listen, God bless you.
Amen.
I see them. You're paying your tithe, a lot of you. And thank God for you.
Amen.
Thank God for you. We wouldn't be in this building if it wasn't for you paying your tithe. So we're not saying that everybody's not paying. We thank God for those that are not paying. For those that are not paying, we say, come on up.
Amen.
Step up to the plate.
Yes, sir.
Amen. And watch the Lord do what he said he's going to do.
Amen.
He said, the more you give, the more I give back to you.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
That's the word.
Amen.
The more you give, listen, I get excited when it's time to give. Because I said the Lord's going to beat me giving every
Amen.
Time.
Yeah.
He's going to beat me giving.
Yes,
so I get excited. And listen, apparently there's somebody else out there. A few of you get excited. Because if you get so excited putting your money in an envelope, you forget to put your name on it. We get a lot of envelopes with no names on them.
Amen.
I charge it to you being excited. About what you know the Lord is going to do.
Amen.
The Lord is not short of his word.
Amen. No, he's not.
And I keep saying again and again and again, you take care of the Lord's business and he'll take care of your business.
Amen.
Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
I believe it does. Come on, ushers. Tithes and offering, if you need an envelope, raise your hand. We have several ways of giving and we keep reminding you so you can't say, I don't know how to give or where to put it. You can give in person, You can give it in the drop box around the west side of the church, or you can give it through Giveify. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Now, if you need an envelope, raise your hand. We have time for you to get your envelope and fill it out. If you need an envelope, raise your hand, and usher will get them to you. Apparently, everybody got your envelope. We're ready, ushers.
Please stand. Amen. Amen. Let's go to God in prayer. Amen. Our Father in heaven, first of all, we come to say thank you. Lord, we thank you for life. We thank you for health. We thank you for strength. Lord, we thank you for allowing us to see one more day that you did not promise us, Heavenly Father. Lord, we thank you for your son, Jesus Christ, Heavenly Father, who took our place on Calvary over 2,000 years ago, that we would have the right to the tree of life, Heavenly Father. Lord, we ask the Lord, Heavenly Father, Lord, forgive us of our sins, Heavenly Father. Lord, search us, Heavenly Father. If you find anything that is not like you, Heavenly Father, any word, any thought, any deed that we may have done, let's, Lord, you just forgive us, Heavenly Father. Lord, bless this church, Heavenly Father. Bless this pastor, Heavenly Father. Bless this offering, Heavenly Father. Bless the ones who gave, bless the ones who wanted to give but had not, Heavenly Father. Bless it that they may be given next time. We lift up those who may be going through sickness right now, may be going through bereavement right now, those who are homeless, those who are hungry, those who are incarcerated, those who are in mental institutions, we lift them up right now, Heavenly Father. Those who are struggling with addictions, we lift them up right now in the name of Jesus. We ask all the blessings in your Son Jesus' name. We pray and give thanks. Amen. Amen. All things. All things come of thee, O Lord, and of thine own have we given thee.
Yes.
Yes. I will sing.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Oh Lord. There is a reason a personal reason behind everything that our God allow for us to do. We don't do things just for the sake of doing them. Whether our reasons are acceptable by God or not, there is a reason for everything. And I say that God allowed, because if he did not allow it, we couldn't do it. Whether it's right or wrong, whether it is right or wrong, God can stop us from doing it. But since he made us as a free will people, he allows us to commit ourselves to such things as such that goes against his will. But yet and still, there is a personal reason behind everything that we do. Personal. I will sing hallelujah, O Lord. I will give, or I will render up unto you the highest level of praise in which you has enabled me to. And just one of the reasons behind committing myself to such is because I always know that there are some blessings on the way, and I'm gonna get mine. And we can't beat God giving, no matter how hard we try. So it should be hallelujah all day and all night long unto our God. We should exert ourselves to the max toward God. And he has made such a way available for us to do such. We can give unto him our highest praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. People may look at you like you're crazy if you're walking around all day long hollering, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. But there's nothing crazy about the reason. You know that you can't beat your God
forgiven no matter how hard you try. And the highest praise that we can give is hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I want my God to maximize my blessings. I want the best that God has stored up with my name on it. I take them, but I prefer the best rather than the crumbs, which falls from my master's table. Why settle for crumbs?
Amen. Amen.
When you can have the best.
Yes, sir.
All right. I take crumbs because I know I'm not always at my best. But I'd rather have the best. And no matter how good God has already been to us, the best is always yet to come. Because there's another hallelujah. In each and every one of us, and all day long, if not verbally, mentally, and spiritually, it should be hallelujah. Hallelujah. I give unto you the highest praise. Just because you're God and you're God alone. And I know there are some blessings along the way. And I'm gonna get mine. Let's give this great choir another round of applause. When man's ways are pleasing unto God, he will make even your enemies to be at peace. We should be, if possible, walking around bent over backwards in doing all that we can to please God. And the first step in pleasing God is coming to know, Lord, what will you have for me to do? And the will of God toward us, his people, pertaining to such subject matter is right here in this book. We don't have to go seeking nor searching. For any way or any means to go about working such a work when all we have to do is study. To show ourselves approved unto God. Because a workman needeth not be ashamed to rightfully divide that which God has promised such a person. Heaven and earth may pass away, but my word. If nothing else is, it's going to stand.
Amen.
And it will not go out and return back unto me void. But rather, it is going to accomplish that which, back to pleasing God,
amen,
which pleases me. Sing one of those things that pleases the Lord is to make a joyful noise unto the Lord and to serve him with gladness and to come before his presence with singing.
Amen.
And I say unto these men, ye have truly blessed the Lord through song. Amen,
amen.
Amen. And there are some unclaimed blessings up there in the choir loft.
Yes, sir. Amen.
You see, you can only stake claim to your own.
Amen.
To those which God willed towards you. But since there's some empty seats, there's some unclaimed blessings up there.
Amen.
In any place in the Lord's house,
yes,
where you see an empty seat, that empty seat represents an unclaimed blessing.
Amen.
Between Brother McLeod, Brother Love, that's a blessing. Neither one of you can have it. But you can assist someone else in receiving.
Amen.
So can you.
Yes, sir.
You can be a blessing to someone else by assisting them in claiming that unclaimed blessing that may be to your right or to your left.
Amen.
And don't ever forget, the eyes of God are upon you, and that you can't beat him giving. So no matter how great of an opportunity that you assist God in bringing to manifestation for that person that take that seat next to you, God is going to outdo that blessing that you assist them in receiving with the one he's going to bless you with. Because you can't beat God giving. No matter how hard. So I wonder this afternoon, how many of us know of others who needs a blessing?
Amen.
There are some blessings on the way. And they too can get theirs. Let us make sure that we find ourselves doing the best that we can to be a blessing unto someone else. And that can very easily be one unclaimed to your right or to your left, out front or behind. That's waiting to be claimed. Our scripture reading this afternoon comes from the 55th chapter of the book of Isaiah, the 55th chapter.
Amen.
The 8th and the 9th verse. And there we will find these words. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, saith the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts.
Amen.
So let us think on this thought. The ways of God. The thoughts in which our minds should be stayed upon. His ways. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, saith the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Can you imagine the distance that your thoughts and your ways, how far they could separate you from God?
Amen.
Just your thoughts and your ways. Your thoughts and your ways. Can separate you further from God than we can even imagine. Neither one of us in earth has ever traveled such distance before. The distance between heaven and earth. We only dream about it.
Amen.
Hope, believe, and trust God that one day we will be able to make such a journey from earth to heaven. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, saith the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than yours. That within itself is enough food for thought to leave this sanctuary with enough on your mind and on your heart to keep you occupied to this time next Sunday. Thoughts and ways. And what difference they make. Great in a negative way. In what great difference they can make in your life. They neither draw or drive. Draw you as close as you can possibly humanly be to God.
Amen.
Or drive you. Just as far as you can possibly be. And still alive.
Amen.
The only thing that might be possibly able to carry you a little further away is death.
Amen.
Dying and going to hell.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Every sense, we're talking about the ways of God. Every sense of the fall of man,
yes,
God has been using unfavorable situations and conditions in order to draw man back to submitting unto the will of God. Every sense, the fall of man, our God has been using unfavorable situations and conditions in order to bring man back to submitting unto the will of God.
Amen.
Unfavorable. Which suggests that everything which takes place, everything upon the face of this earth has God's fingerprints upon it. Simply because all things were made by him. And without him, there was not anything made that was made. And that is why our scriptures tells us that we are to receive all things as if though they are from God.
Amen.
And that in all things to give him thanks. And when we receive all things as if though they are from God, and then in all things give him thanks, that means praises and thanksgiving will constantly be up on our lips. Because we know that regardless of what the nature of my situation, regardless of what's the nature of my circumstances, regardless of what's the nature of my trouble, my God has his hands on it. We're talking about praises and thanksgiving constantly being up on your lips, because you know with blessed assurance that every trouble, every trial, and every tribulation that you experience in your life, God has his hands on it. It has been Father filtered. One of the ways in which we ought to go by seeing the fingerprints of God upon your situation is that we have to view that situation through the eyes of faith. Because when you view that situation through the eyes of faith, the eyes of faith can show you some stuff that you cannot see through the eyes of doubt, question,
amen,
or uncertainty. When you view that situation through the eyes of faith, the eyes of faith can show you some things that you cannot see through the eyes of doubt, through the eyes of question, or through the eyes of uncertainty. We are to receive all things as if they are from God, and then in all things give him thanks. And the way we go about seeing the fingerprint of God upon all things is that we have to view those things through the eyes of faith. Because when we view it through the eyes of faith can show us some things that we cannot see through the eyes of doubt, question, or uncertainty. Case in point.
Amen.
when Pharaoh's army drowned in the Red Sea. There's no doubt in my mind that all the Egyptians back in Egypt started to cry out, what a tsunami that was indeed.
All right, man.
When David sinned against God by numbering Israel, it displeased God and it stirred up the anger in the Almighty God. And God sent pestilence down on the land of Israel. And it took the lives of 82,000 Israelites to quench God's anger. And there's no doubt in my mind that all the survivors was left crying out, what a deadly pandemic that was indeed. Sound like us, doesn't it?
Come on, doctor. All right, man.
Come on, doctor.
Yes, sir.
Come on now. What a deadly pandemic that was indeed. We're talking about the fingerprints of God being upon all things. When the sins of Solomon and Gomorrah came up before God in the form of a stink in God's nostrils. And God said unto Abraham, Abraham, I want you to go around to the cities of Solomon and Gomorrah. And if you can just find 10, just 10. Righteous men, then I will spare the two cities.
Amen.
And Abraham went seeking and searching high and low, but he could not find 10.
Amen.
And then God rained down fire and brimstone from heaven and consumed the two cities. But in the midst of the cities being consumed, no doubt in my mind that all the inhabitants were running around crying out, what a deadly electrical storm we're having indeed.
Amen.
But
yes.
When Moses saw the children of Israel, when Moses saw Pharaoh's army drowning in the Red Sea, when David looked out across the kill field of Israel and saw the dead bodies of 82,000 Israelites, when Abraham turned around and looked back towards Solomon and Gomorrah and all he could see was smoke, Moses cried out, David cried out, Abraham cried out, what a mighty God we serve indeed. And Black Chapel, when God woke you up this morning and enclosed you in your right mind, gave unto you the operation, the use of your faculty, food on your table, clothes on your back, roof on your head, you should be crying out, what a mighty God we serve indeed. When you see it through the eyes of faith will show you something that you cannot see through the eyes of doubt, question, and uncertainty. And man's conduct in general is influenced by either one of three motives. Either by way of reason, by way of interest, or by way of feelings. But there can come a time in your circumstances when your circumstances can rob you of all three of those motives. Rob you of your feelings to hold on. Rob you of your interest to hold on. Rob you of your desire to hold on. And all you have left to hold on to will be the principle of your salvation. And that is that the just must live by faith. The just must live by faith.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Only way. No other way.
Faith coming by hearing and by hearing the word of God.
Yes, sir. Amen. Glory.
And all faith comes with instruction. Your ways and my ways.
That's a distance between them and heaven and earth.
Yes, sir.
My ways come with instruction.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Always.
Yes, sir.
He puts it in writing.
Amen.
Man's conduct in general is normally and naturally influenced by either one of three motives. By way of interest, by way of reason, or by way of feelings. But there can come a time in your situation when your situation can rob you of all three of those motives. robbed you of your reason to hold on, robbed you of your interest to hold on, robbed you of your feelings to hold on. And all you have left to hold on to is the principle of your salvation, and that is that the just must live by faith. And that reminds me of our forefathers, our slave ancestors. I say again, that reminds me of our forefathers, of our slave ancestors. Those who were born citizens of those states. Not citizens of the United States of America. But rather citizens of those states of need that could nobody supply but God. Those states of brokenness that could nobody fix but God. Those states of bondage that could nobody deliver them from but God, but God, but God. Many of our slave ancestors never knew what freedom was. Because freedom was breaded out of their intellect and out of their conversation. It was breaded out of their intellect and out of their conversation. Breaded out. Never knew what freedom was. But God. God will not have his people ignorant to the wiles of the devil. I say again, God will not allow his people to be ignorant to the wiles of the devil. Bred it out. Knowledge of freedom had been bred it out of their intellect. Bred it out of their conversation. But God. God intuited inside of them a divine curiosity. A divine curiosity to know what freedom was. And it was their faith in that divine curiosity that enabled them to endure over 200 years of our slave husbands having their wives taken out of their beds in the midnight hour by their masters and dragged out into the darkness where they was misused and sexually abused. 200 years of our slave mothers and slave fathers having their children ripped from their mother's apron and taken out to the slave market and sold to the highest bidder. 200 years of slave wives having their husbands hog tied and dragged out to the nearest tree and hang by the neck until they were dead, simply because while during their master's hog killing season, those husbands held back a little piece of meat to feed their starving children. But let me tell you something, suffering teaches us things about God that we cannot learn from no other source. How can you know that your God is all that you need unless he allowed you to experience some situations in life whereas God is all that you have? How else? Suffering teaches us things about God that we cannot learn from no other source. How can we know with a surety that God is all that we need unless he allow us to experience some situations in our lives where God is all that we have? You see, our ancestors, our slave ancestors, were founders of anticipating praise. That praise that goes up in view of your future deliverance. That praise that goes up in view of your future breakthrough. That praise that goes up in view of your future victory. Anticipating praises, anticipating shadows. That's why you don't see white shouting saints, because that's a black thing. It's a part of our inheritance. And I wonder this morning, Black Shepherd, do we have any black saints in the house this morning? Do we have any black saints in the house this morning? Those who know with a surety that some way, somehow, the Lord will make a way, and you're willing to give God his prop before your blessings come, before your healing come, before your deliverance come. Do we have any anticipating praises who don't have to wait until the battle is over? You're ready to shout. You're ready to dance. You're ready to praise God right now for the blessings that stored up for you, the healings that stored up for you, the deliverances that are stored up for you. There's some blessings on the way, and I'm going to get mine. All I have to do is line up with God's source, line up with God's way, and see will God make a way out of nowhere. Tighten up this gap. Close up the gap. not the relationship. Draw nigh unto he. See and know with a surety that no matter what's the nature of your situation, no matter what's the nature of your circumstances, no matter what's the nature of your condition, God has his hand on it. And it is being father filtered. And I will not allow no more to come upon my child than that in which he or she can bear. But suffering teaches you things about me that you cannot learn from no other source. How can you truly know beyond the shadow of any doubt that your God is all that you need unless you allow him to allow you to experience some things in life, whereas God is all that you have. They were born citizens of those states. Citizens of those states of need that could nobody supply but God. Citizens of those states of brokenness that could nobody fix but God. Citizens of those states of bondage that could no one set them free but God. And look at us now, reaping the harvest of born again believers who once upon a time, less known knowing God, didn't even know what freedom was because it had been bred out of their intellect. Bred it out of their conversations. Bred out. What a God. What an amazing God we serve. Now we can read. We can write. We can think our own thoughts. We can go our own ways. But you know what the Bible also said about that? That my people are becoming wiser, but weaker. All of this knowledge and all of this wisdom that God has enabled us to corral, throw a rope around, pull in and claim unto ourselves. As the old gospel song used to say, don't let the devil ride. Because if you let him ride, he will do all that he can to drive you as far apart from God as the heavens are from the earth. They're not there just for the sake of being there, but they are there for spiritual food for thought. Let us think God's way. Let us act God's way. Let us go God's way. Let us close up the gap which lies between us and our Father. Because it can be the distance of that of heaven and earth. The door of the church is open. God's ways. God's ways. God has placed us in a position where we have never ever it's been in before. He has blessed us with opportunities that we have never ever had before. And yet and still, so many of us have that crab mentality where we believe in catching hold to anything that's above us and putting forth our greatest effort to pull it back down. So many of us out there destroying that which God gave life to because of your ways. Those are the ways of man. to steal, to kill, and to destroy, because we were born property of the devil. And his three objectives are to teach us to steal, to kill, and to destroy. And what a work that's being done in each of those capacities. Stealing, killing, and destroying. And Jesus said, I come that you may have life and have it more abundantly. There's some blessings on the way. And all of us should be saying, I'm going to get mine. A blessing is something that God bestows upon you after you will have won God's favor. Favor. By all means, make sure you stay in favor with God. Regardless of what you have to release and let go of, make sure that it doesn't hold you back from being in favor with God. The door of the church is open. By way of letter, Christian experience, or candidate for baptism. I say unto our viewing audience, the same invitation that goes to the sitting audience goes out also to you. The door of the church is open. Something has been said or something has been done throughout the activities of our worship service this morning that God used to enlighten you upon various subject matters pertaining directly to you. And your conclusion is, if you hadn't already, I want to come to know Jesus in the pardon of my sin. Or if you hadn't already, I want to become a part of God's church family. Not just a part of the body of Christ, because God has placed other benefits, other privileges in earth to serve you. And that is a Christian family, a Christian home, a place where we can come collectively and worship and praise our God. As he say, forsake not the assembly of ourselves together. That's a gift that God has put in place just for you, the believer. If you're such a person, something been said or done throughout the activity of this worship service that God has used as a tool to draw you into that spiritual state of mind that you're presently in by saying yes unto the Lord. Yes, I accept Jesus as Lord and Savior. Or yes, I want to become a part of the church family here at Black Chapel. Then all you have to do, key in the comments section or inbox your name, your telephone number, and the word virtual member, and I will personally contact you, and we'll go from there together. The door of the church is open. By way of letter, Christian experience, or candidate for baptism, the door of the church is open. The door of the church is open. If you're here, will you call? Will you come? God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. We thank God once again this morning for all of that in which he has allowed to be said and done throughout the activity. We thank God for all of our visitors who came out to be a part of our service this morning. We thank God for all of our guests. Let us continue.
Our Pastor Black Chapel family, we have several coming for special prayer. Several coming for special prayer.
Thank you. I'm coming today with sort of a heavy heart. My daughter-in-law had to be airlifted here She's in pretty bad shape. She's in university and in intensive care. And I'm asking for prayer for me and my family and the sweetest daughter-in-law God could give a person. And pray for me, too. I'm having some problems with my heart. I am now wearing a heart monitor, and I'm going in tomorrow to see the results. So please lift me up in prayer. Thank you.
Amen, amen. Church, I'm coming to you on behalf of my family. I'm going to ask my son to come down, Perry. But not only Perry, for his classmates, his teammates, and all the young men. I'm just going to say all of our young youth. The enemy is really trying to attack them, and he's coming hard. And so I plead the blood of Jesus over mine. I decree and declare that no weapon formed against him shall prosper. He has a praying mother, a praying father, and a praying church. And I'm asking you all to touch and agree with me in prayer that the devil is a lie, that this child will be who all that God has called him to be, and that no weapon formed shall prosper. He is a man of valor. God has called him to ministry and to teach. And guess what? And I'm going to stand beside him. Listen, he said that the enemy was going to come. He said the weapons were going to form. Lord God, but we stand and believe that all, and not only for him, I stand in the gap for every mother who has a black male in this community. Amen. We got to be praying, women of God and men of God, for our children, because the devil is on, he's on the loose because we're not praying and we're not teaching and standing in the gap. So I'm standing in the gap for mine, yours, and I'm asking you all to touch and agree with me that God will be done on heaven and in earth. Amen.
Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Once upon a time, but never no more. When we did not have the precious privilege of coming before the throne of grace, of coming before the mercy seat, and making our personal request known unto God. I said it once and I say it again. We cannot beat God given, no matter how hard we may try. Look at us now. The Lord has opened up heaven and granted us direct, individual, and collective rights to approach the throne of grace any place, at any time, for any reason. We don't have to wait till a certain time or certain season or for a certain person to bow their heads and humble their heart and go before God in your stead. Father, we thank you. We thank you for making heaven so available here in earth, because where the presence of the Lord is, there is heaven. Oh yes, there is. And heaven is in this place. He's in this sanctuary. It's in this sanctuary because this place has been dedicated and concentrated as a house of prayer, the house of worship, the house of praise, your house, Lord. It has been given back to you, that which you gave us stewardship over. This is your house. And we know that you're God who's able to keep your house. Always on post. Never slumber nor sleep. Father, you say we have not because we ask not. And Father, we have a collective group of born-again, baptized believers, mothers and fathers and mother-in-laws. And we carry all kinds of titles before the throne of grace. But not one is there that you don't know about, that you're not aware of. So Father, as a collective group, we come beseeching the throne of grace. We come seeking the mercy seat. First of all, to say, Lord, we thank you. We thank you for giving us stewardship over that in which we now have a great concern about. Stewardship over our children. Stewardship over our in-laws. stewardship over our daughter-in-laws, stewardship over our neighbors, stewardship over our co-workers, stewardship over the school system. All of these entities, Lord, they're here because of you. Because you made all things, that there was not anything made that you did not make. All of it represents property of God. And we know that you're a father who's able to take care of his own. So, Father, we're lifting up your own back unto you in different forms, in different shapes, in different titles. But, Lord God, they all belong to you. And we're claiming saving grace. We're claiming saving mercy. We're claiming saving healing and saving deliverance from whatever it is that they may suffer and need to be delivered from or through, Lord God. We claim it right now in the name of Jesus. We claim in the knowledge and the wisdom for all the specialists that you fill our hospitals with. Give them the knowledge and wisdom to be able to properly diagnose all of the challenges that challenge these bodies of ours. Sister Blue and her daughter-in-law, Lord God, we pray that you just send that healing spirit upon their bodies right now in the name of Jesus. We know that your grace is still sufficient enough for thee. Yes, it is, Lord God. And we claim your saving grace. We claim that medication that, Lord God, Jesus had in the hem of his stomach when that woman who had an issue of blood for 12 long years just say, I believe. If I could just touch the hem of his garment, then I would be made whole again. And she exercised her faith. She reached out and she touched the hem of Jesus, and healing came upon her body. You say that if we pray, have faith, and believe, whatsoever we ask in thy name, believe it and we shall receive it. These women of God have verbally opened their mouths, Lord God, and made that request known unto you. We know that your ears are always open unto your people. Your arms are always outstretched, saying, come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, and I'll give you rest, rest, rest from all the troubles of this world. So, Father, we claim rest. We claim rest in the form of whatever form of healing needs to take place on the challenges that all of them, that all of us are being challenged by. We claim healing. We claim deliverance. We claim victory. We claim the prize right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, the one who came that we may have life and have life more abundantly. We claim life. We claim healing. We claim deliverance. We claim breakthrough. We claim victory. We claim deliverance over all. In Jesus' name. You say that the name of Jesus, every knee must bow, and every tongue must confess that he is Lord. We claim Jesus. We claim Jesus right now. And we claim our healing. We claim our deliverance. We claim our breakthrough. We claim our victory. We claim all the spoils that you've laid up in life for each and every one of us. We stake our claim in the name of Jesus. Be it done. Be it done. Be it done. Be it done. In the precious name of Jesus. In the precious name of Jesus. We say it's done. It's done. We say amen. 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 Go in faith with that blessed assurance, knowing that the hands of God are upright. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. We do indeed thank God for all that he has allowed to be said and done throughout the activities of our Sunday morning worship service. We thank God for all of our visitors. We thank God for all of you, the prayer warriors. Let it be known that our God has ears that hears all of our prayers. And not only does he give ears to them, but in his own way, in his own time, he's going to bring closure upon them. He is going to bring into manifestation that which best befits us, his people. Because his will toward us never changed. And that is that we be of good health, sound mind, and prosperous. And that that person that's pointed God's way and under no circumstances will even look back, less on, turn back. May God continue to bless you and forever keep you. And let us not forget, as we go out across the week, let us make it our personal business that next Sunday there will not be an unclaimed blessing. Amen. On your right, on your left, out front, nor behind. Because too many of us know of too many people who suffer great need to be blessed in an unlimited form of shape and fashion. Let us be about our Father's business. If there's nothing more, let us stand for our closing song and benediction. Until we meet again, may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide from henceforth and forevermore. Let us all say together. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. You are dismissed. God bless you.